In this movie, I will show how to create some of the available chart types in BioNumerics. I will first create a frequency bar graph displaying the frequencies of a selected category. First, I will define field states for the serotype field in my database. I right-click on the field, select the first option and let BioNumerics create all possible field states in my database. I check use colors to give each serotype a different color. The serotype cells are now colored based on their content, and I will use this coloring in my bar graph. I select all entries in my database using the Ctrl+A shortcut combination on my keyboard. I call the charts wizard by pressing this button in the toolbar and choose frequency bar graph colored as my chart type. I select country as my category and the serotype states as my coloring. Pressing the finish button will plot the data in the charts window. In this example, I will compare a set of entries based on two groupings. I make sure all entries are selected in my database using the Ctrl+A shortcut combination on my keyboard. And I press this button to call the chart wizard. I choose the contingency table option. And choose my two groupings in the next step. Country and genus. I press finish to plot the data in the charts window. The cells are colored based on the member counts. Blue for only one member, going over green, orange to red containing the highest number of members. Pressing F4, unselect all entries. To select all entries contained in a cell, hold the Ctrl key and click on a cell. Changing the order of the rows and/or columns can be done in the Properties dialog. As an example, I will sort my columns alphabetically. To view the plotted data in 3D, I select my two groupings in the Data Source Overview panel and launch the Create Chart wizard again. I select 3D Contingency Chart . Select my categories again and press finish to plot the data. With the mouse, I can rotate the image. In this example, I will create a bar graph displaying the character set of a selected entry. I first select a few entries in the Database Entries panel using the checkboxes on the left. I will create a new comparison by pressing this button in the Comparisons panel. The selected entries in the main window are loaded in the Comparison window. I call the Charts wizard and select the famed character set from the list. I choose the bar graph option from the list and choose any of my selected entries in the next step. In the last step, I can specify some additional settings. I select name to plot the names of the fatty acids on the x-axis. The bar graph is updated and each bar has a length proportional to its value. I will now add a second bar graph. I enter the chart wizard again, select bar graph, and select another entry from the list. The graph is updated in the charts area panel. I will now create a profile chart that plots the values of a selected character for all my entries. I select all entries in my database using the Ctrl+A shortcut combination in my keyboard. I will create a new comparison by pressing this button in the Comparisons panel. All entries that were selected are now loaded in the comparison window. I will now create groups based on the content of the genus field. I right-click on the field, choose the last option and confirm the creation of groups. The groups, number of group members, and the group colors are summarized in the Groups panel. I call the Charts wizard. I select my comparison entries and choose Profile Chart as chart type. I choose a character value from the list. And press Finish to plot the data in the Charts window. I can sort the chart according to the character values. I right-click on the C20 value and choose the Sort option from the list. Next, I will add genus names as chart labels. I right-click on genus and choose the label option. To include the species name in the chart labels, I need to create a new derived property. I select both the genus and species fields and I launch the derived property wizard. I choose merge and replace the comma by the space. I will now add the new property as label to the chart. To do so, I right-click on the new derived property and choose the label option from the list. Finally, I will add the strain numbers of my samples to the chart. I select the strain number field from the tree Right-click and choose the point label option. To add a second profile, I can select another character from the list, right-click and select the value option. The chart now includes two profiles. Pressing F4 will unselect the current selection in all windows. Finally, I will now plot the group colors of my genus groups on the plot. I right-click on the color grouping of my comparison and choose the color option. The data points are now colored based on the genus names. In this example, I will create a scatter plot, plotting the values of two selected characters. I select all entries in my database using the Ctrl+A shortcuts and create a new comparison by clicking on this button in the Comparisons panel. I call the charts wizard and select my comparison entries. I choose scatter chart as chart type and select two characters. Pressing Finish will plot the data in the Charts window. Each dot corresponds to an entry. Double-clicking on a dot opens the entry card for that entry.